Hello everyone, let us discuss about smallpox. Firstly, we'll talk about its main key features. So smallpox, it is an acute infectious respiratory disease which is caused by the virus variola. That is the reason smallpox is also known as variola. Fine? So it is a type of pox virus. Now what are the clinical features of smallpox? It is first initiated by a sudden onset fever, which may be mild to moderate grade. Then comes the headache, and which may be accompanied by back pain as well as vomiting also. And sometimes convulsions may be present, especially in children. The main feature of smallpox is the rash. Now the rash begins on the third day of fever. After the fever subsides, usually it takes 2 to 4 days for all the above pro-dormant features to subside, that is the fever, headache, backache, etc. So at the third day of fever, a rash appears, which is centrifugal. Now what does it mean by centrifugal? That is, first it appears on the face, then on the forearms and arms, legs, and then it goes to the trunk part or the chest part. Okay, so it is from the face, then extremities to the inside. That is why it is known as centrifugal, extremities to inside. Then after that, the rash, it will slowly and gradually develop into a macule, which is a flat lesion. Then comes a papule, then comes a vesicle, and finally pustule. Pustule is pus filled vesicle, fine. And ultimately it will form a scab, and scab marks the process of healing, I should say, that the disease is slowly regressing. And finally, a scar may be left. Now, if you can see in this image, I have just shown it to make a comparison, a basic idea between smallpox and chickenpox. That smallpox rashes and all these stages, the evolution begins from the face, then face, extremities, and then inside. Fine. Whereas in the case of chickenpox, the rash is centripetal, that is from inside to outside. First it begins in the trunk or the chest area, and then it goes to the extremities. Also, if you can see, the palm and the sole regions, they are not or almost very less involved in chickenpox, whereas they are commonly involved in smallpox. Then coming to few important dates we need to remember, few important years as well, because you must be knowing that smallpox is eradicated from the world. Eradicated means at a global level the disease is no longer present. Okay, there is no active case of the disease. Then coming to the years, in 1967, WHO, that is the World Health Organization, they led a campaign to eradicate, and the technique used was surveillance and containment. Before that, mass vaccination was also given, but the technique used in this campaign was surveillance and containment. Talking about India, so these dates are very important, mind you. The last case, it was seen in 1975, 24th May 1975, and India was finally smallpox free on 5th July. It was declared smallpox free on 5th July 1975. So you need to remember the year 1975. And just 5 years after India got completely smallpox free, the world was also confirmed. Smallpox free or global eradication took place in 1980, but the last case was confirmed in 1977. Last case was confirmed in 1977, whereas the World Health Assembly, it confirmed the global eradication in 1980. Fine. So 1975 and 1980. Then coming to what if a case of smallpox still appears, even though it is eradicated. The smallpox talks, they are still present in Russian Federation and United States, as well as in few, it is also reported that few other countries like Japan and Iraq, they also have smallpox talks. But you need to remember, Russia and United States, they officially have smallpox talks. Fine. So the virus is still present. Only the disease has been eradicated. Now I was here that what if a smallpox case reappears even after post eradication time? If the case appears, then how do you define that this particular case is of smallpox? So the case definition for a confirmed smallpox case it includes these many steps. And before that, if you find that it is a confirmed case of smallpox, then you have to report it to the WHO. Fine. You have to report it to the WHO. Now, what are the requirements for it to be a confirmed case of smallpox? So, an individual of any age presenting with acute onset of fever, that is more than 38.3 degrees Celsius or 101 Fahrenheit, malaise and severe prostration with headache, backache occurring 2 to 4 days before rash onset. Okay, we saw yeah, this is the feature of smallpox, fine. Acute onset fever which lasts for around 2 to 4 days before the onset of rash. Then coming to and, mind you, this is and, fine. And subsequent development of a maculopapular rash starting on the face and forearms, then spreading to the trunk and the legs, and evolving within 48 hours to a deep-seated, firm, hard and round, well-circumscribed vesicles and later pustules, which may be umbilicated or confluent. So what do they mean? The vesicles here in smallpox, they are deep-seated, they may be umbilicated like this, or they may be confluent. In chickenpox, the lesions, they are not umbilicated, fine. And also in chickenpox, the lesions, they are superficial, whereas here they are deep-seated. So that is one criteria. Then what other? And lesions that appear in the same stage of development, that is, if something is occurring on the face, then all the, those must be vesicles or pustules. Means we saw here the different stages, right? Macule, papule, vesicle, pustule. So if something is present on a particular part of body, then only that kind of lesion. If macule is present, then all macules should only be present on the face. Alright, so same kind of lesion must be present on this given part of the body. And no alternative diagnosis explaining the illness. There should not be any alternative diagnosis which may explain the same diagnosis, as well as laboratory confirmation, which will finally detect whether it is a smallpox virus or not. Yeah, and the laboratory confirmation, it cannot be done in a simple laboratory. You need to contact the CDC, that is Centers for Disease Control in that particular case, which will perform the diagnosis in some biosafety level 4 kind of laboratory. Fine. So that was about how to report a confirmed case of smallpox. Fine. Now then, lastly, we'll talk about the vaccines. So you must be knowing that first vaccine for smallpox, it was developed by Edward Jenner, who injected a cowpox virus. Fine. And that is how the vaccine was developed by Edward Jenner. And you know, smallpox, it is the only human disease to have been eradicated by vaccine. Yeah. It is actually. Then what are the current vaccines prepared from? They are prepared from vaccinia virus. Yeah, so it is present, the vaccine itself is present from a vaccinia virus. The vaccinia is also a type of pox virus which is of mild variety, and the name of the vaccine currently available is the ACAM 2000. Okay, and you know, these vaccines, they are regularly injected to the US military personnels and other people in US military or army which are more prone to bioterrorism, because smallpox, it is an agent of bioterrorism. Okay, because you know, the stocks are still present, I told you, in US, Russia and many other countries as well. So in future, bioterrorism may again be done by smallpox as the weapon. Fine. And physical stockpile of this vaccine is held by the WHO headquarters, Switzerland. So the vaccine stockpile is still available. So in case, in future, if needed, it can be utilized. Around 200 million people or doses can be given. That much stock is present. So that was all about smallpox. Thank you very much.